When the night has come and the land is dark and the moon is the only light we'll see. No, I won't be afraid. No, I won't be afraid. Just as long as you stand by. So darling, darling, stand by me. Oh, stand by me. Oh, stand by me, stand by me. If the sky that we look upon should tumble and fall, or the mountain should crumble to the sea, I won't cry, I won't cry, no, I won't shed a tear, just as long as you stand by me. And darling,
hi there. For those of you who don't know me, my name's Casey Chen. And since I couldn't be there in person today, I just wanted to record this to say a few words about my friend Jim. Jim was somebody for me who was always a support in my life, always interested in what I was up to, what I had going on. To pursue a career as an artist is something that I have wanted to do for years, and I am endeavoring to do that this year. And I know Jim was and always would be 100% behind that. I think Jim would really prefer that I am where I'm at and that I could be doing what I really love to do. And that's something he would be behind 100%. So I think that really speaks volumes to who Jim was for me in my life. I will miss his wit. I will miss his optimism for life, his sense of humor, the way that he loved Trish. And Jim was just a good friend. And Jim, I love you. I miss you. And Trish, I love you. And thank you so much for giving me the opportunity to say something here today. And be well. Thank you.
She's a good girl. Loves her mom. Loves Jesus. In America too, She's a good girl. She's crazy about Elvis. Loves horses and her boyfriend too. And it's a long day living in Reseda. There's a freeway running through the yard. And I'm a bad boy, 'cause I don't even miss her. I'm a bad boy for breaking her heart.
got the revolution.
Hey, I'm dancing down the street.
Got the revolution, got the revolution.
Ain't it amazing all the people I meet?
Got the revolution.
We are volunteers of America.
Tell the world I'll never say enough, 'cause it was not said to you, and that's exactly what I need to do if I end up with you. Should I give up, or should I just keep chasing pavements, even if it leads nowhere? Or would it be a waste, even if I knew my fate? Should I leave it there? Should I give up, or should I just keep chasing pavements, even if it leads nowhere? Myself out and fly around in circles, waiting as my heart drops and my back begins to tingle. Finally, could this be it? Oh, should I give up, or should I just keep chasing pavements, even if it leads nowhere? Or would it be keep chasing pavements, even if it leads nowhere? Or would it be a waste, even if I knew my place? Should I leave it there? Should I give up, or should I just keep on chasing pavements? Should I just keep on chasing payments? Oh, should I give up, or should I just keep chasing payments, even if it leads nowhere? Or would it be a waste, even if I knew my fate? Should I leave it there? Should I give up, or should I just keep chasing payments, if it leads nowhere?
On the floors of Tokyo, oh, oh, down in London town to go, go. With the record selection and the mirror's reflection, I'm a dancing with myself. And when there's no one else inside, I'm in the crowd and lonely night. Well, I wait so long for my love vibration, and I'm dancing with myself. It'll give me time to think. If I had a chance, I'd have a one to dance, and I'll be dancing on with myself. Oh, dancing on with myself. Oh, dancing on with myself. Oh, well, there's nothing to lose, and there's nothing to prove. Well, I'm dancing on with myself. We'll be right back.
cause it'll give me time to think. If I had the chance, I'd ask a woman to dance, and I'll be dancing with myself.
My conception and memories of Mom and Dad may seem not as exciting or outstanding, even childish, but that's because I'm always 17 when I relive those memories. Dad knew how to encourage. Whenever my spirit was down or I was doubtful of my abilities, he would say, "Bring out the brave sauna." It always worked somehow. Many of the things I tried for the first time, like overcoming shyness, fear, and culture or self-developed stereotypes, were encouraged by him, like trying to ride a bicycle, a horse, swimming, one of my brightest memories, jet skiing or taking a motorbike trip with him, taking up karate and even washing his old Chevy and Harley. My first fishing experience was again with him at the Lake Higgins. He was both curious and patient. To avoid culture or age-related awkwardness when he was asking questions, we agreed That be the case, I'd say too many questions, and he wouldn't inquire further. Yet he was so aware of so many aspects of life that when I came back from a date one evening and found him working, as always, a glance at me was enough for him to brighten up, saying, "Oh, I see you've had your first kiss." Be it with my biological father, I'd have a tough time. He was consistent. Although Mom taught me waking up independently for school, Dad would still check on me to make sure I'm really up. He was always up earliest. It is true that when a girl chooses her future husband, she seeks the best features of her father. Well, it has turned so that my husband shares many traits I value in Dad. He was an observer. For an exchange student, Dad is the perfect representative of the best traditions of the American culture. Apart from sharing all responsibility in the family and always being there for us, he was open to my non-Americanness. He would really listen and correct my speech, try the unusual dishes I made and things I did. One day in winter, I took out the carpet into the snow-packed backyard and started dusting it in the snow, like we do in Armenia. One day I filled all the vases at home with the lilacs from the garden. One day I made a vegetable barbecue on his grill. One day I started knitting him a sweater. Whatever I did, never made an objection, but curiosity, patience to understand and to accept the outcome, as strange and clumsy as it could seem. He was the head of our family. It may sound impossible, but a year with Mom and Dad has given me such a load of experience, skills, and horizons, created such a bond between us that I see myself as partly the product of their upbringing. I always thought I could call any time, and as inseparable one body and soul, Mom and Dad together would greet me from the other side of the Skype screen. Like he said after returning from the hospital the first time, "I'm not used to not being capable of doing everything I did or helping Mom. I'm not used to his absence from our everyday life." Still, even at his hardest time, Dad didn't just think of himself only. Through his example, he taught us to be led by the brave part of ourselves. See you later, alligator.
Good morning, Trish. I've been thinking a lot about you lately, and I've been thinking about Jim, and we played a lot of Mexican Train this weekend, so it was easy to think about you. And just lots of great memories, like coming over and, you know, having dinner at, 11 o'clock at night or something, and staying up and talking to you guys. And, sometimes we play a little something, other times, you know, just talking about life. And I always really appreciated the space in which I could talk about my adventures with the Warner Group or the Air Force Academy or, you know, just everything. It was, you know, just really enjoying the two of you as my Academy parents, you know, and my sponsor parents. And yeah, I just, you know, I've been holding off sending this because I want to say just the right thing. And here I am at 5:45 in the morning getting ready to do a big call, global conference call. And thought, okay, I'm not going to wait anymore. So I love you. Jim is definitely present for us from time to time and in my heart, and so are you. Okay, I hope I see you soon. Bye.
Soon to see if I'm happy. sisters and brothers. Up, up the long, delirious, burning blue. I've topped the windswept heights with easy grace, where never lark nor even eagle flew. And while with silent lifting mind I trod the high untrespassed sanctity of space, put out my hand and touch the face of God.